Award is possibly the highest honor that a college can bestow upon a graduate of West Hills College, Coalinga. This year, we're pleased to bestow the honor upon Mr. Michael Lynch. Mr. Lynch is a nationally recognized award-winning playwright of 39 plays. Yeah, 39, that's a lot. How many people?
Now, I am a kid from Coalinga, and I'm the luckiest man in the world. Shakespeare tells us all the world's a stage. Well, my stage world began just a few steps from this very place. And that theater over there, just behind this gym, was 1966. And as luck would have it, a new drama instructor had just arrived in Coalinga, and his name was Bill Powers.
Yeah.
We called him the boss. And the boss introduced me to a brand new world, a world of color and a world of light. And his brilliant insights, his incredible talent of directing and design, and his absolute love of teaching, and the sharing of his knowledge to his students has inspired me to this very day. Went on to Fresno State, where I met another protege of Boss Powers, and that was Dennis Gallegos. At Fresno State, Dennis starred in my very first Coalinga play. It was called Dead Leaves, with his heartbreaking performance as a disabled veteran. Then on to graduate school at Northwestern University in Chicago, and there I wrote yet another Coalinga play, and it was called Queen of the Horn-Toed Derby. I sent that play off to a theater in San Francisco, the Wildback Theater Company on Mason Street. They produced it, it had some success, so they asked me to be their playwright in residence, which I was for 10 years, and wrote a whole bunch of plays. Many of them that was set right here in Coalinga. Now, I was at the One Act Theater where I wrote a play called San Joaquin Blues. This was a play that was a tribute to my father, Wayne Lynch. Now, my father was an oil man. He was a Coalinga oil man. And more important to him, he was a Standard oil man. And he was excited to see his son's play on a subject that he dearly loved. Now, ironically, my father died just 2 weeks before the world premiere of San Joaquin Blues, and he never got to see it.